been 3 years of hard work, and now it's just time to get out in the water and give it a crack.
Got time to get it on. Been a long wait, so looking forward to it.
Today is race day on a beautiful day in San Francisco.
Just 15 seconds away from the moment where the entire sailing world holds its breath. It's Oracle Team USA to leeward, Emirates Team New Zealand to windward as they approach the line for the start of race number one of the 34th America's Cup. There's the cross. Oracle Team USA have done it. A lead change, and the Americans are now in the lead. Simultaneous tax as Emirates Team New Zealand closes the door on Oracle Team USA. The first race of the America's Cup goes to Emirates Team New Zealand.
This is the scene on the San Francisco Bay in September showdown, leg 3 of 5. Race number 5, and Oracle Team USA had the lead for the first 2 legs. They gave it up on leg 3, and now they trail by a substantial amount to a very fast Emirates Team New Zealand boat. Now remember, the Americans were hit with a 2-point deduction, so although they have 1 win, they have yet to record a point. Leg 3 seems to be the kryptonite of Oracle Team USA. Right now, the defenders look to be absolutely shell-shocked, needing 10 more to retain the cup, and the Kiwis needing just 5 more wins, and they have called a halt to the day.
We feel like we need to regroup, really have a good look at the boat. We've got some time now, especially tomorrow, to really have a good look at it, and it's obvious we've got to make some changes.
On the far right-hand side of your screen, normally a helmsman playing the role of tactician today. At mark number 1, it is the defenders of the cup, Oracle Team USA, with their biggest lead so far here in the America's Cup.
Starting to get soft in there. I think right here is good.
You're seeing Tom Slingsby, the strategist, being far more vocal today than he's been in the past with Kostecki in the boat.
As the Americans get to mark number 4, still over 35 seconds behind the Kiwis, and barring a major mistake by Dean Barker, which we have not seen during this entire campaign, it will be the Kiwis striking again. So they make the tactician change, but it does not yield the results that Russell Coutts and Jimmy Spithill were looking for.
I think the question is, imagine if these guys lost from here. What an upset that would be. They've almost got it in the bag. So that's my motivation. We feel we've got just as much chance to win this, and we're going to do everything we can.
The America's Cup is all about development, and it's not how you start the competition, it's how you finish the competition.
Clearly we weren't fast enough upwind, and we weren't tacking well enough. We've learnt from the New Zealanders what they were doing, and we adapted to that.
Oracle will now have the starboard tack advantage again. They're tacking better, and it just looks like they're going quicker through the water all the time. Their changes have made a difference here, Todd. Bottom line.
New Zealand almost capsized.
Oh, my gosh.
Got
attack,
got attack, got attack.
And a rattled Kiwis crew have to make this rounding very cautiously, and now they'll try to track down the Americans, who are off and running as they make their way to the finish line. If Oracle Team USA can hold on and get this win, their third victory, but their first point, what does this mean to the camp?
The vertical learning curves on these boats are still staggering. How much faster they go every day. These guys are on to something, clearly. It's just a different boat, a different team. Just tremendous how they've massaged a bad situation and created a good one.
Nice work, lads.
I think the biggest change we made to the boat was how we sailed it. The technique and how we trimmed, steered, sailed the boat, that came from off the boat, from the other sailors who weren't actually sailing. Russell Coutts, John Kostecki, Philippe Presti, all of that support network around us, we utilised to 100%.
At mark number four, the race is on. The Kiwis have relinquished a huge lead that was over 300 meters, and now it's down to about 85 meters, but just one leg to go as the Americans are close behind. Day number eight, race number 11, belongs to Emirates Team New Zealand. The Kiwis now just one win away from the America's Cup. All right, Jimmy, give us a prediction, and what's the message going to be to you and the crew?
It's not over. It's a long way from over.
And Spithill gets the dominant hook. Just as I was saying, it's going to be hard for him to do. Dominant hook. Jimmy Spithill nails it.
The Americans firmly control this one, and they have to be. If they lose another race, the America's Cup finishes their hands and goes back to New Zealand. For the America's Cup. Can the Kiwis get it? If they win this race, they take home the cup. If the Americans get it, they force a final race for the win. And a simultaneous attack, and the Americans are out in front.
Wow! A lead change, upwind. Incredible pace by Oracle.
As they come to the line, the comeback is complete.
We've worked very, very hard to come back from where we were. And the guys want it, you know. You can just sense it on board and you can sense it around the base that the whole team just wants it.
This ability to come back from such a desperate position and not to flinch, not to point fingers at each other, but to just get stronger, that was incredible. And particularly for Jimmy and the sailing team, they came out fighting every day and getting better and better. That was so impressive to watch that.
Oh, they both have huge skids piled in by Oracle.
This one is for all the marbles. The 34th America's Cup will go to the winner of this race.
This is it. Work your asses off.
This is a comeback like international sport may have never seen before.
America's Cup will stay in America.
One of our biggest strengths as a team, looking after your teammates. Doesn't matter what sort of adversity we're facing, 8-1 down, whatever the issue is, we always look out for one another. We're a team, and that's what got the job done.